Tonight, an aid ship is bringing the bodies of two photojournalists out of Libya, one of them with ties to Pittsburgh. Chris Hondros was no stranger to war.
In fact, he dedicated his life to covering conflicts around the world. Channel 4 Action News anchor Sally Wiggin just spoke with his best friend right here in Pittsburgh. Sally?
That's right, guys. Chris Hondros was one of the top war photographers in the world. But he loved Pittsburgh, where he lived for a time in 2001. He visited frequently, in large part because of his best friend and fellow photojournalist Jeff Swensen. I caught up with Jeff this afternoon as he pored over Chris's work.
It is a picture of them in graduate school at Ohio University, on the edge of promising careers in photojournalism.
I look at his face, I remember the conversations we were having.
They reacted quickly when Libyan army trucks were seen running down the road.
Chris eventually won the Robert Capa Gold Medal, one of the highest honors in war photography. He was killed Wednesday in the rebel-held city of Misrata, where Muammar Gaddafi forces were firing rockets and tank shells into residential areas. Also killed with him, Oscar-nominated filmmaker Tim Hetherington.
I talked to him at length on Sunday about it because I had read in the New York Times that they were using cluster bombs in Misrata. And I said, why didn't you come home?
But Chris told Jeff that he was getting great photos.
Now we're waiting for whatever, like that maybe. Whatever that might be. Probably some rebel blowing his own head off with an old munition of some kind.
He was in his element. The photos were happening. If you look at the photos that he shot, the day he was hit, you know, he was making great photos.
Back in 2001, Chris made Pittsburgh his home, but 9/11 happened and he returned to Getty Images and then on to every major conflict zone on the planet. He was engaged to be married in August, and friends from all over that planet intended to celebrate with him.
He was really good at watering friendships all over the place, and he made us all feel loved.
Jeff told me that Chris was no adrenaline junkie. Rather, it was his calling to document the human condition in its rawest forms. He held many exhibitions here, and Jeff intends to have another one, a retrospective of his friend's brilliant work and life. Sally Wiggin, Channel 4 Action News.